Battlebrook Memorial Flight operates 6 Spitfires, 2 Hurricanes, a Lancaster, a C-47 Dakota, and 2 Chipmunk aircraft, primarily for training. The aircraft are flown by regular RAF aircrew and are serviced by regular and reserve technicians and engineers. These aircraft can regularly be seen in the skies over the UK from May to September each year. They are flown to celebrate and commemorate public and military events, from state occasions such as Trooping of the Colour, to major air shows and flypasts for public events. Real BBMF are proud to have HRH Prince William, Duke of Cambridge as patron. The motto of the Royal Air Force Battle of Britain Memorial Flight reflects our mission and honours the thousands of men and women in the air and on the ground that gave their lives for this country and noble pursuit of freedom. Ladies and gentlemen, virtual BBMF, lest we forget. As in the real memorial formation, the display is carefully choreographed and flown in a way that displays the aircraft in sympathetic light, without the need to overstress or potentially damage these iconic machines. Royal Air Force Battle of Britain Memorial Flight, or BBMF, operates from RAF Coningsby, a Typhoon base in Lincolnshire. The mission of RAF BBMF is to maintain the priceless artifacts of our national heritage in an airworthy condition, in order to commemorate those who have fallen in service of this country, to promote the modern day Air Force, to inspire future generations.
Rolling out.
Running back in now. From the left. Formation. Gentlemen, keep your eyes high and to the left for Spitfire TE-311.
BBMF's Spitfire Mark 16 TE-311 was taken on charge by the Air Ministry on the 8th of June 1945, exactly 1 month after VE Day. TE-311 was built at the Castle Bromwich Shadow Factory in Birmingham as a low-back, clipped-winged Rolls-Royce Merlin 266-powered LF Mark 16E. It was delivered from Castle Bromwich to No. 39 Maintenance Unit at Killearn in Wiltshire on the 16th of June 1945 and placed directly into storage. It was allocated to the Empire Central Flying School Handling Squadron 5th of October that year, and then all with spells on the ground, long periods of storage in between bouts of flying, TE-311 flew for a total of only about 12 months. When she was transferred to non-effective stock in December 1954, she had only 30 hours on the clock. For the next several decades, Spitfire TE-311 was kept on the ground, including use as a static exhibit, spending over 12 years as a gate guardian at RAF Tangmere and RAF Lenton, 27 years as a static display aircraft RAF Exhibition Flight. She was brought into the BBMF fold in 2000, intended to be used only for spares recovery. But in 2002, a 10-year rebuild to flying condition was commenced. This was led by BBMF's brilliant chief technician, Paul Blacker. The Mark 16 took to the air for the first time in 58 years in October 2012, and then joined the BBMF's fleet of airworthy Spitfires. Good view there, she banks away of the clipped wings, giving a much higher roll rate at low level. Eagle-eyed amongst you, you'll notice that TE-311 is currently painted to represent clipwing Spitfire Mark 16, TD-240, which was the personal aircraft of Polish commanding officer number 131 Polish Wing, Group Captain Aleksander Gabreski, BMKW, DSO and DFC. And he flew her from April 1945 to mid-June 45, with his code letters SZG, his personal boxing dog motif on the port engine cowling. At the time, 131 Polish Wing was stationed at Baron Rusch, or BE-113 airfield, as it was called, in Germany. Gabreski flew 6 wartime operational sorties in TD-240, including 4 dive bombing enemy positions. As TE clears to the right, keep your eyes to the left on the Spitfire V7350, delivering the one. P7350 is the oldest airworthy Spitfire in the world, and the only Spitfire still flying today to have actually fought in the Battle of Britain. P7 is believed to be the 14th aircraft, 11,989, built at the Castle Bromwich Shadow Factory in Birmingham. She entered service in August of 1940, flew in the Battle of Britain, serving with the 266 Squadron, 603, City of Edinburgh Auxiliary Air Force Squadron. While serving with 603 at Hornchurch, on or about the 25th of October 1940, she was involved in combat with an ME-BF-109 and forced to crash. She was quickly repaired at No. 1 Civilian Repair Unit, Cowley in Oxfordshire, and flew again on the 15th of November, only for 3 weeks after the crash landing. Up until recently, repaired bullet holes could still be seen on the port wing. Notice the difference in the planform wing here between P7 and the earlier Mark 16 TE-311. It's got the beautiful elliptical wings with full tips, whereas T has a much shorter clip. After April 1942, she was relegated to support duties, serving with the Central Gunnery School in the 57th Operational Training Unit, ending her operational career with the 1980s. Being forced to crash land wasn't the only damage P-7 suffered during the war. She also had three other Cat B flying accidents, and these are at Tangmere, Hornchurch and Sutton Bridge. Having survived the war, P-7 was then sold for scrap to Mrs. John Dale Limited in 1948 for the princely sum of £25. Fortunately, the historical significance of the aircraft was recognised, and she was generously presented to the RAF Museum at Killearn. Restored to flying condition in 1968 for the epic film The Battle of Britain, she was presented to the BBMF after filming was completed. P-7350 wears the markings of New Zealand-born Al Deer, it's Kiwi 3, and he had these markings applied during his time in 54 Squadron with code letters KLB, and the Kiwi 3 emblem on both sides of the fuselage under the cockpit. The real P-7 was given a thorough maintenance last year at the Biggin Hill Heritage Hangar, which is black flying with the real BBMF, and here of course the virtual Battle of Britain Memorial flight. Ladies and gentlemen, the lovely baby Spitfire P-7350, pride of the virtual Battle of Britain Memorial flight. We've seen some very graceful flying from both Spitfire pilots today. It's been an honour to display in front of you. We all know what's coming next. Ladies and gentlemen,
Lancaster. Low and in from the left.
Lancaster.
BBMS piece de resistance. Lancaster PA-474, better known as the City of Lincoln. She wears PA-474 will always bear the coat of arms of the City of Lincoln right at the nose. Past couple of years, Lancaster's been painted to represent two aircraft. On the left side, PA-474 wears the markings of 460 Squadron of the Royal Australian Air Force, coded ARL or L for Leader. Leader carries the nose art of a kangaroo playing bagpipes, indicating the Australian and Scottish backgrounds of its crew. Right side carries the markings of 50 Squadron, with code letters VNT, representing the Lancaster flown by Flying Officer Douglas Milliken, DFC, grandfather of former BBMF leader, Squadron Leader Andy Millie Milliken, 27 of his first tour of 30 operations. Lancaster first flew in 1941, and the type celebrates its 80th birthday this year. The bomb doors open here, good view of the bomb bay. The 7,377 Lancasters produced, 3,249 were lost to enemy action, a further 200 destroyed or written off in crashes. Lancaster Bomber had a crew of 7. Pilot, navigator, bomb aimer, flight engineer, wireless operator, mid-upper gunner, rear gunner. Today, the Lancasters routinely flies with a crew of 4 or 5 plus ground crew for landaways. Bmerf's flight crew is comprised of two pilots, flight engineer, and one or two navigators, who can be seen perched meerkat-like behind the pilot's armoured headrest as they try to guide the aircraft to display venues on time and on target. Scooby's got the gears and the flaps down there, hoping she'll run in past the show centre, 45 degree timeout, climb. BBMF air and ground crew board the aircraft through a door on the rear right of the aircraft. Just after the door is a small brass plaque showing the Royal Air Force Bomber Command badge, its motto, strike hard, strike sure, and an inscription to remember the many, counterpoint to the few of the Battle of Britain. It commemorates all those who flew with RAF Bomber Command during the Second World War, especially the very many who lost their lives carrying the fight to the enemy. 22,743 Lancaster Air Crew did not return from operations out of a total of 55,572 Bomber Command Air Crew died during the Second World War. So fighters rejoin the bomber now. It's worth mentioning that the RAF isn't just about pilots and aircrew. There's also engineers, work on the ground crew side, as well as support staff, cooks, drivers, logisticians, IT and technical staff. Every single person helps get every single aircraft airborne. To remember those who gave their tomorrow for our today. Ladies and gentlemen, you'll be watching Virtual Battle of Britain Memorial Flight.